eventually our ad produces a result, and when that happens, we will broadcast it. The broadcast of the result happens exactly as before in Tomasulo's algorithm, except that the tag we carry for the result is the Rob entry, not the reservation station number, because we have already freed the reservation station. So what we do is we now broadcast the tag of Rob 6 with a value, let's say 15. Just like with Tomasulo's algorithm, this value and the tag are now given to the reservation stations, and they normally capture the result based on the tag as before. This result is now broadcast to the reservation stations, and they capture this result if they need it. And those that need the result of this instruction will capture the value of 15, just like we did in Tomasulo's algorithm. So this is not changed. Without the Rob, we would now also capture this result in the register and update the RAD to point to that register. With the Rob, we don't want to write to the register yet, so we write to the Rob instead. So this broadcast value now goes to the Rob, and we write 15 here, and mark the instruction as done. Also, the result of the instruction is not going to be in the register, so we do not update the RAD to point to the registers. In fact, the RAD is still pointing to the correct place. The result of the instruction is in the Rob now. So we don't do this here. After broadcasting its result, the instruction would be completed in Tomasulo's algorithm. With the Rob, we are still not done with it. Yes, we have computed the result and marked the computation as done, but we have not deposited this result in the registers. For that, there is an additional step called commit. To commit this instruction, we must first commit all of the previous instructions. So each cycle, we test whether the next instruction at the commit point is done, in which case the commit point can move on and commit this instruction. So eventually, the commit point will reach here, and now we will test whether this instruction is done, find out that it's done, and commit it. The committing of the instruction consists of actually taking this value, 15, and writing it to the register that the instruction is supposed to write to, in this case, R1. So 15 will be written here. And also, we need to update the RAD because it's pointing to the entry Rob6. That entry will be freed after we commit this instruction. So instead of pointing to Rob6, now we can point to R1. So really the updating of the RAD for writing to the register has moved from the broadcast time to the commit time, because that's when we are actually updating the registers. And after committing this instruction, the commit point will move even further, so that the next instruction to commit will be here, and that completes our reorder buffer processor step by step for one instruction. As you can see, many of the things are happening exactly the same as in Tomasulo's algorithm. Some of the things have changed, like pointing the RAD to the Rob entry instead of the reservation station, writing to the Rob on broadcast instead of the register file, and also we have added a step here for committing. Also, we can free the reservation station on dispatch, not on broadcast. And finally, we need a new step for actually committing the instruction.